Hello, my friends. Today's video is all about the metaverse and what that means for the future of learning. So you've likely heard about Facebook's recent name change to Meta, and you may or may not know that this name change has drummed up a ton of interest in the metaverse. Now, there's not one single metaverse where every human is going to be living, at least not at the current point in time, but the metaverse is just a word for this digital world where people generally have an avatar representing themselves that they can run around, interact with other people, play games, build their own kind of house or workspace or what have you. The possibilities are honestly endless. A metaverse is just a virtual world that you can enter and interact with other people. So no one owns the metaverse. There are many different ones. So this video will be an exploratory video where we explore some of these metaverses together, and I share some of my thoughts that I've had so far about what this might mean for the future of learning. So let's dive into it. The first metaverse I want to show you here is called Decentraland. So Decentraland, you can see the URL right here. It is a bit complicated to get started because this is based on like crypto and it incorporates NFTs and all of that. So if you do want more content on this, let me know. But this is just going to be some overviews and just some quick demos of the different types of experiences you can have. So how Decentraland works is there are a limited number of these plots of land. So this is like a virtual world, and different people or organizations can buy these different plots of land. Okay, so it's decentralized. People can really build whatever they like on these different plots of land. So this one right here is this several plots of land called Lemursive that I just kind of stumbled across, and I'm showing you it because it's kind of like a little learning experience. So I climbed to the top of this like little mountain thing here, and you can click on these different speech bubbles and see some content. Welcome to this mountain. People are cutting down trees on my island and I don't like it. Will you help me replant trees here? So you can kind of run around through this experience. Like there's little like lemurs jumping around. let's interact here, see what this is. I'm a black blue-eyed lemur-a-die, but only the boys are actually black. So you can see like some fun facts. You can see this is kind of like a learning experience. And then we have this sidebar when we're in this land where we can learn more about what this is all about. So welcome to Lemursive, a game where you can actually explore Madagascar. And then there's an effort to like combat the deforestation in Madagascar. So pretty cool. And the interesting thing about that is you can run into other people in the wild. You can go through this with a friend, or you can kind of go over to a different plot of land and you can be in a completely different experience. So how I've thought about using this, which would be cool, is like if I were to buy a piece of land, I could put like a co-working space there. Like I would need a 3D artist. You build kind of like, you know, just a cool co-working space with like plants and big windows, and then you could host events there. You can share a screen from a computer into the metaverse, which is kind of cool, and it could just be like a meeting space or a community hangout for people to come together and connect. I think the idea, and obviously the graphics aren't that great, but the idea is that there's more of a sense of like presence when you're in an environment like this. You can customize your avatar, you can chat, and you can literally run around and see all of the other people who are in that same space with you in a way that's a little bit different than when you're on like a webinar and you're in just like a general chat. So it's kind of cool. It's like a gamified learning experience in a way, just because you are in this virtual world. So it's pretty cool. I do want to show you another one that I've stumbled across. It's actually very close to this one. The map is like huge. Like there's like 100,000 different little plots of this land. But I, of course, this one caught my eye because it's kind of e-learning related. It's called Quiz Zone. So we're going to hop over here. I'm not going to actually play one of the quizzes right now, but we will take a look at it together. And you can see there is a little bit of loading time when you jump between different zones like this, but you can basically teleport anywhere you'd like to on this map. All right, so Quiz Zone. Okay, so you can kind of check in for a quiz. I don't know if we're going to be able to see it very well right here. These people tried to like it's like monetized in a way. We're not going to get into it, but you can see when other people join here, it's going to ask you a series of questions based on a different topic. And then based on how you want to respond to that question, you can run to the different number. And when the timer runs out, it will tell you which answer choice is correct. And you'll get points if you answered correctly. And then there's like a leaderboard. So I could definitely see, you know, in a learning environment, we could definitely incorporate games like this. But it's just obviously a little bit more immersive. Now, I don't know if companies are actually going to invest in a space like this. Like when I first found Decentraland, I'm like, this is cool, but why would I bring in people from my audience to this world where other people, you know, random people can enter who know nothing about instructional design or e-learning or, it's expensive too. Like land right now, like the cheapest land you can get is like 15 grand for like a tiny piece of land in the metaverse. Won't dive too deep into that, but what I was thinking is like, there is clearly a big opportunity here for companies who can make like custom metaverses for an organization. So if I wanted like a custom meeting space only for people who I invite, and then we could all get together, that obviously seemed like it was promising. And a couple of weeks later, I found a metaverse that does exactly that. So I don't know how to pronounce this one's name. It looks like Virbela. But you can, just like Decentraland, you can make an avatar, you can customize them. And this is like their demo world. So it's kind of cool. Like it looks like there's a lot to explore. I haven't done a ton of exploring in this yet, but we can go into this auditorium and check it out. So it's like we're in like a lecture hall almost. We can go up on stage. We could present to the audience here. We can run like all the way to the back of this lecture hall and grab a seat and let's sit there. And there we go. I mean, we obviously don't have a very great view. The controls are a little bit clunky. Like I imagine a lot of this stuff has a long way to go, as you can tell from the graphics, but you can see people are sharing actual screens here in this virtual space. So let's hop over here and go to their website. It's pretty cool. Yeah, you can check this out, Virbela.com. The Enterprise Metaverse is here. It brings people together to work, learn, meet, and train in an immersive virtual world from anywhere. So I went to their like remote learning solution, and it's the next generation in education. So we can see what like ideas they've kind of come up with here. I clearly, a lot of the drive to this type of thing is, you know, we've been in lockdown, people have been working from home, working at their desks. And like I said, experiences like this really give you a sense of presence. And when you're there with, like, I'm imagining, like, imagine, you know, big companies like Amazon or something have this virtual campus where there are maybe hangout spots, workstations, meeting spaces, and maybe the counter argument is like, oh, it's a little silly, it's, you know, a waste of time. But I think it does, it definitely is an experience when you're in a space like this, running into other real people, chatting with them. It kind of simulates what it's like in the real world much better. I mean, especially if the graphics were better, but it simulates what it's like in the real world a bit better than the tools that we're used to using already, like Zoom and Teams and all of that good stuff. So a lot of possibilities here. Virbela, that's what I imagine. And I don't think that the pricing and stuff is there yet. Like if I want to host an event with 1,000 people, I don't even want to imagine how much that would cost on a platform like this. So again, the tech has a little ways to go. Something I was excited about for Decentraland, let's hop back over here, is years ago, I wrote this article when I was excited about VR, and I was like, imagine students being able to go into this like virtual reality. Like if they're learning about Charles Dickens, for example, or the Victorian era, imagine being able to like go to a street in Victorian London and Charles Dickens himself, you know, himself is like talking to you and like walking you through the streets of Victorian London and like talking to you about his novels. So I had that, I was like thinking about how cool that would be. And now like in these metaverses, you could create an experience like that. Like you could kind of get some Victorian artwork. You could make this Charles Dickens character and you can have them talk to people who come and like go on this quest with Charles Dickens. So not sure these specific tools or these specific metaverses will be the answer, because again, it can be a bit expensive to get involved right now since there is a limited amount of land in these metaverses, or in Decentraland at least. But clearly a lot of possibilities. I know there, you know, we're at the beginning with this kind of stuff. So eventually it is going to be in VR headsets. I would imagine there are some already that are VR. So they will only be getting more and more immersive. And that's probably a good time to talk about Facebook or Meta's, you know, formerly Facebook, now Meta. They have this Horizon Worlds and like Horizon Workrooms and all of this. They are on that shift into the metaverse. So I don't have my VR headset all hooked up right now, and I haven't checked this out, but the video looks pretty cool. So this is Horizon Worlds. This was like just announced, and it's the same kind of thing. You make an avatar, 3D artists can create like really cool kind of environments and experiences. So pretty cool that, you know, you can imagine getting together with your coworkers in an environment like this, and it can feel much closer to a hangout than maybe a Zoom session would. So a lot of possibilities there. And then there is Horizon Workrooms, which does seem to be a more corporate work-related environment just for people to come together. So a lot of possible criticisms. I would love to see what some of you are thinking in the comments. Like, is this just a glorified, I don't know, what is it, a glorified like Zoom call? or do you actually get excited about the possibilities here? So I do think in some form, this is the future, right? This, there's more presence, there's a better sense of community when you can see people, you can kind of customize your avatar. But I think there's a good argument to be made against it. Maybe in the beginning, it will be more distracting than anything. I imagine this tech is not the most accessible. Like for me, it's second nature, right? I've been gaming since I was like 5 on a computer. So I can figure out the controls and stuff pretty quickly. But people who may not be as comfortable on computers, or who may have or may not be able to use computers as well as other people, they may be missing out on some of these experiences. For example, like VR headset, I was so excited about VR development and stuff, and I tried out all of these different experiences, but it would just make me so, so motion sick. Ones that involved a lot of movement where I would literally have to take it off. I would be like sweating. And as a gamer, that wasn't very exciting for me because I was like, yeah, I'm not going to be able to enjoy some of these experiences just because of my body, I guess. So I think that will be a barrier to adoption. It's just like, you know, and especially because the tech isn't there. If we're hosting an event in Decentraland, like it's kind of buggy. So it's like we can have 100 people in the room, but you can't see everyone's chat. We might have a live stream, but it will like be like pausing and we'll need to refresh. So again, the tech is not all the way there. You see what the graphics look like, but hopefully this just kind of gave you an idea of like where we're headed in the future. I think we are inevitably headed there. I've heard there's like a rumor about Apple releasing a new headset, like an AR VR headset. Facebook obviously, or Meta, is obviously all in on the metaverse. So it is the direction we're headed. I am very excited about it, especially in this virtual remote work world, remote learning, remote working. These kind of online experiences that can bring us together even better than the current tools. Very, very exciting. And one last thought, like one of the benefits about if you did have a workspace or something in Decentraland, again, feel free, hop out, but I'm just gonna, these are just things I've been thinking about. Imagine if we had like a workspace or something in Decentraland, and then it's like, okay, you leave work and then you can go to like play some game together, or, you know, do some entertainment experience together. So that's kind of the idea. It's like some people are calling Decentraland like a game, but that's not exactly what it is. Decentraland is like the universe, and then developers can make games within that. But when you leave that individual game, you're still in the metaverse. So you can go play another game, or you can go meet your team at their workspace. So that was really cool. Another vision I had is like, you know, when you're like downtown in a city and it's like, it is more corporate, it would be really cool to see something like that in the metaverse, or if there is going to be like a LinkedIn type metaverse where maybe there is like a banking district, or maybe there is a district where you could go to find a marketing team or something like that. So instead of just like browsing different websites, you're kind of walking into different people's buildings in these virtual worlds and maybe chatting with someone at a front desk. Again, it's just kind of like that melding. I don't know if that's even the right word. It's just kind of this like, yeah, it's kind of like virtual world is meeting the physical world. And I think that's what Web3 is all about. So still too early to tell which companies are going to be leading in Web3. Seems like Meta is really committed to it, but very excited for what the future holds. Let me know what you think in the comments below. I have not seen people really talking about this in the learning space yet, so very, very excited to see what you all think. And if you found other tools or if you're excited about other ideas, please let us know in the comments. Hopefully we can get a good discussion started here, and I will see you all in the next video.